On the morning of July 12th, 2012, I thought I had the world by the tail. Everything was good. All my family was healthy. I was retired, didn't have to work just a couple hours a week. I was over in Calhoun County on some property that we owned over there, and I was checking on my cows and just pondering what I might have in store for the next week or so. And all of a sudden, I stepped in a stump hole. I went down hard, and when I did, I felt a strange burning, tingling sensation in the back of my leg, and I thought, oh no, I've been snake bit. So I hopped out of that hole as quick as I could and realized I couldn't walk. So I laid there for a few minutes, and I knew that it wasn't going to be good. I could tell from after I had time to kind of gather myself. But what I didn't know was what lay in front of me. Just I guess the best way to describe it is just a series of unfortunate events, which included 10 different surgical procedures over the next 6 months. A blood clot that went from below my calf all the way up in my groin, and just filled my lungs with emboli, with clots. And every doctor that looked at my x-rays and looked at my report said that I don't think I can make it through this if you're lucky to be alive. And I guess I was going to go through and kind of give y'all a description of each one of these procedures and what all took place, but Jerry said keep it to 10 minutes, so that would have taken about an hour just to explain everything that had happened to me over the course of 6 months. When you go through an ordeal like this, you go through just a tremendous range of emotions. First of all, you experience fear. Lord, what's going to happen to me? How's this going to turn out? And then you experience doubt. Well, I don't know if I'll make it. And then you get a little angry about it. Why does that happen to me? Everything is going so good. And then you get a little depressed. That's a tough emotion to deal with. And if anyone's been through any sort of trauma like this, either an accident or some sort of disease state or whatever, the depression is a tough nut to crack, and it's kind of hard to cope with it. But you also experience hope, and finally you experience Thanksgiving. And when you're laid up like I was for about 6 months, where I couldn't do anything, I'm sure y'all remember, I had what was called a wound vac attached to the back of my leg. It kind of was tethered me to the house, and I kept that on for almost 6 months. So I had a lot of time to lay around and think about things and reflect on things. One thing that I did was I kind of realized what's important in life, what my priorities were, the things that I one time thought was just the top of my list, that soon got down there lower on the list. Things that I knew were important, they became even more important. Some of the things that I felt carried me through this ordeal was my family, for one. They were, the greatest support that any man could have. my wife was there by my side all the time. And my grandson Gus, he was about 3 years old. And every time he'd come in the room where I was at, he had just lit the room up. So it gave me hope. It strengthened me. It took my mind off of what was going on. And of course, both of my sons were very supportive. Josh came up and took off work for about a week and stayed with me. And John was there every day, just about. And they were, you know, they were a constant source of strength for me. And our pastor was a great source of strength also. He was there at nearly every one of my procedures, with the exception of one or two that we had to do so quick that nobody knew about, that it was all over with. And I'd be laying there waiting on him to wheel me up to the operating room, and here he'd come strolling in and grab me by the hand and pray with me. And that always gave me courage and strength to go on and deal with what I was having to deal with. My church family was a constant source of strength. I know that every week, two or three times a week, y'all of the church family would pray for me. And I was on prayer chain after prayer chain. And people, those prayers, I could feel them. I could feel God's strength working through those prayers. And anytime anyone said they were praying for me, I could feel God's presence. And I just want to thank each and every one of y'all for lifting me up in prayer like they did. Like I said, I just can't explain just how much that meant to me. And of course, the Word was a great inspiration. I didn't have any particular agenda to study the Word. I would just open it up and look at it and read it. Every day I'd find something new in it. Of course, I went to the book of Job and compared Job to what I was going through. And like Job, God restored me again. So I'm grateful for that. But all of these people that touched me, they were all God's messengers. I saw God through them, and they all strengthened me because they were all godly people. And I just can't thank you enough for all the prayers and the thoughts and the kind words and everything that you as a church and as a pastor have done for me throughout this ordeal. And one other thing that I did while I was recuperating was I listened to a little bit of inspirational music. And one song that I listened to every day was a song that Candy's recorded years ago called God on the Mountain. And I just want to read a verse of it. And this really, like I say, every day I listen to it, every day it strengthens me. Life is easy when you're up on the mountain. And you've got a peace of mind like you've never known. But then things change and you're down in the valley. But don't lose faith, because you're never alone. Because the God on the mountain is the God in the valley. The God of the good times is the God of the bad times. And when things go wrong, He'll make them right. And the God of the daytime is still God in the night.
Amen.